Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Plant Water Relation and Mineral Nutrition. In that, we are studying topic What is transpiration and its various types. Transpiration is loss of water from leaf. Today we will be studying what is this process and what are the types of transpiration that is available in plant system. Transpiration can be defined as loss of water from the upper surface of the leaf. Whenever sun's energy fall on the leaves, the stomata, or you can say the small openings present on the upper surface of the leaves, precisely open. The guard cells present on the stomata opens, and once the stomata of the leaf is exposed, water is lost from the leaf, and this process is called as transpiration, which takes place in every plant present in the universe. Now, for this kind of transpiration to occur, leaf has to be present, sun has to be present. Apart from this transpiration, which is called as stomatal transpiration, in which stomata plays a vital or critical role. 90% of the plants do stomatal transpiration with the help of guard cell opening and sunlight in the form of photons. There are other forms of transpiration which are even available, and the two other forms are cuticular transpiration and lenticular transpiration. Whenever I say cuticular transpiration, we all have seen arum leaves. Arum leaves basically grow inside water. They have a waxy coating or surface present on the leaf. Cuticular transpiration is nothing but cuticles which are present at the lower surfaces of the leaves, which respire or which remove certain amount of water from them. Cuticles are openings below the surface of leaf, and 5 to 7% of transpiration takes place with the help of cuticular transpiration. Basically, all the plants which stay inside water, that is lotus plant, arum leaves, all the water or hydrophytes try and do cuticular transpiration. For cuticular transpiration to take place, sunlight is not an important factor. The last type of transpiration, lenticular. Whenever we go in morning and we touch the bark, or you can say the stem of a plant, there are chances that we may find the stem or the bark to be wet. One reason is nothing but dew drops have fallen on that bark. Another reason, if you find the stem or a bark of a tree wet during the course of the day, is lenticular transpiration. Lenticels are nothing but small openings which are present on the stem and the bark of a plant as protrusions. When I say protrusion, enlarged surfaces, and through this lenticels, basically the cellulose present inside the wood material of a plant cell help to form lenticels, and these lenticels are nothing but which help in lenticular transpiration. From the bark, or you can say the woody surface of a plant, if water is evaporated or removed out, it is called as lenticular transpiration. Whenever a plant has excess of water present inside them, they try and go for stomatal as well as lenticular transpiration. Transpiration. Transpiration can be defined as loss of water from the upper surface of the leaf, which takes place in the presence of sunlight. Loss of water is carried out by the opening of stomata or guard cells. There can be three types of transpiration which is available in plant kingdom. Those types are stomatal transpiration, lenticular transpiration, and cuticular transpiration. The different types of transpiration are: the first one, stomatal transpiration, which occurs inside stomata, which are nothing but minute opening or pores present inside the epidermis of a leaf. Whenever sun's energy falls on the leaf, the guard cells open, which expose the stomata, and 90% of transpiration is stomatal transpiration in nature. The other kind of transpiration is lenticular transpiration, which are nothing but small openings present in the bark, or you can say the stems of a plant, which help to remove certain extent of water molecules from them. The third type of transpiration, or you can say cuticular transpiration. In this type of transpiration, basically a waxy coating that is present on the upper and lower surfaces of leaf helps in the process of transpiration. This type of transpiration basically takes place inside hydrophytes. When I say hydrophyte, it means plants which are completely grown or immersed in water. For example, lotus is a hydrophyte. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about transpiration and the three different parts, or you can say forms of transpiration: stomatal, cuticular and lenticular. I hope we all are clear with the concept of transpiration and its types. Thank you.